Open the freezer door, and what do you find? Vials and test tubes filled with frozen blood samples. Thousands of these samples are stored at research labs across the country, including the University of Louisville, which has blood samples dating back to the 1970s.
We archive greater than 10,000 samples from humans with a variety of exposures, and we're able to use collected blood and urine samples to do research on liver disease.
They're called biorepositories, and with modern transportation and the internet, the blood samples stored in Louisville's biorepositories can now be used by scientists all over the world. But that's raised all sorts of ethical questions about the permissions given by the patients whose blood and DNA scientists want to use.
We're studying the ethical, legal, and regulatory issues that come up in biorepositories, which is collecting samples for research purposes.
U of L's Dr. Kyle Brothers has a $1.7 million three-year grant from the National Human Genome Institute to figure out the delicate balance between the patient's wishes and permissions years ago and the need to use their blood, even anonymously, in medical research.
The problem arises, well, we have different permission for different samples that collected all over the country. So how do we put those together and use them and ensure that we're following the requests of each person? We're keeping the promises we made to each person who donated their samples. So that can bring up a number of ethical issues.
Brothers believes that most American patients would be glad that their blood is being used in research, but others may have only intended for their samples to be used for, say, Alzheimer's research. And then there's the increasing worries about DNA and privacy.
There's been changing ideas about what belongs to me. So now we think, you know, the stuff that Google collects about what I search online, that belongs to me and I should have control over it. Many people feel the same way about their DNA, about their blood sample. That still belongs to me, even if it doesn't have my name on it, and I should get to control how you use it for research purposes.
So it's a privacy concern, isn't it?
It is a privacy concern.
Brothers is expected to come up with recommendations, perhaps for universal standards on the permissions needed, without, he hopes, unnecessarily scaring future donors or restricting future research. Matt Cave and other U of L researchers hope so too.
Biorepository participants, have an opportunity through their generous contributions to, enable, development of new diagnostic tests and potentially new treatments through their contributions.